So this is the third in the series of installation theory recap videos. We're at our PVC conduit exercise. So what did we learn when we're installing this job that can be moved forward to those InstTech exams coming up? We've installed a PVC conduit exercise. PVC conduit comes in a standard 3 meter length, and these comes in the four standard sizes discussed in steel conduit. In other words, the diameter of the conduit itself. We're talking diameters of 16 millimeters, 20 millimeters, 25 and 32 millimeters being the four standard sizes. We installed heavy gauge, high impact PVC conduit. Heavy gauge meaning it can withstand the blow from a hammer. Heavy gauge meaning the thickness of the walls. And we discussed in the classroom about light gauge PVC conduit and its applications as well. We installed a ring final circuit using the basic principles laid out in BS 7671 for a ring final circuit in a domestic dwelling. So we used the same principles. In other words, we had a 32 amp circuit breaker in the distribution board. We used PVC, in this case singles, but they were 2.5 millimeters squared. And there was two of them because they were wired in the form of a ring. We had an additional socket outlet taken from the ring final circuit. So we had three sockets, one, two, and three that were on the ring final circuit, but this was taken from the ring final. You know, that is a spurred socket outlet and it's a non-fused spurred socket outlet. And we said in the classroom that you can have as many non-fused spurs as you can at points on the ring. So in other words, we have 3 points on the ring. So we could have three non-fused spurs from that ring final circuit. If we installed a fused connection unit, a fused connection unit similar to this one, but this isn't on the ring, a fused connection unit, which has a maximum rated fuse inside it of 13 amps. If we installed one of those in circuit, we could have as many socket outlets spurred from that point forward as we wanted. So from a fused connection unit, how many socket outlets can we have spurred? An unlimited number. Because the limiting factor being the 13 amp plug top fuse installed within the connection unit itself. We know under the 17th edition wiring regulations that socket outlets rated at 20 amps and below must be additionally protected by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps or less. And we have a 30 milliamp RCCB fitted within our consumers unit. We know as we move towards the 18th edition, that's going to be socket outlets of 32 amps and below must be additionally protected by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps and below. We've installed 13 amp socket outlets on our installation, therefore they are additionally protected by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps or below. We know the disconnection time when 5 times the current is found, which is 150 milliamps, is 40 milliseconds. And we went on and performed that test in the classroom. We know with any PVC, so when we looked at PVC twin and CPC cables in the classroom, as well as PVC conduit, we must install it in a temperature above zero. So in other words, if our conduit was laid on the floor overnight, froze overnight, and we turned up at the installation, we could not install our PVC conduit. We must wait for 24 hours with our PVC conduit in a temperature above zero, so we'd have to bring it in perhaps inside the building, leave it for 24 hours before installing it. We know that PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride as well. On this installation we've used spacer bar saddles, and we know in BS 7671 it says a spacer bar saddle must be supporting the conduit within 300 millimeters of bends, sets and accessories, and we've done that on our job. So this distance here must be within 300 mil, as must this distance here be within 300 mil to support the conduit itself. On this installation we've installed black PVC conduit because we're simulating industrial style installation. However, we are aware of the fact that we have white PVC conduit as well, and we would use that perhaps in offices where it's more aesthetically pleasing to see a white conduit. Our consumer unit we've installed here offers basic protection. In other words, we need a tool or key to enter the electrical enclosure. Also, once we've entered the electrical enclosure, there is a barrier over the bar which is live behind it, offering basic protection. We also know that we can't physically touch any of the terminals within the consumer's unit again, offering basic protection. And we know, and we've talked about it previously, about the IP rating of an electrical enclosure being IP4X on the top surface and IP2X on the sides, bottom and front when the installation is complete. We installed a radial circuit for the smoke detector from a fuse connection unit. We changed the fuse in here to a 3 amp fuse. We installed a 20 amp type B circuit breaker wired in 2.5 mil cable to feed the fuse connection unit. We selected, as previously stated, a 20 amp device here because we wouldn't want to use a 16 in case this had a 13 amp fuse in, and we wouldn't therefore guarantee discrimination, a word that will be changed under the 18th edition to selectivity between our overcurrent protection devices. In other words, if the load here had a 13 amp fuse in, doesn't in our job, but if it did, and we only had a 16 amp fuse here, and there was a fault on the load, we couldn't guarantee the fuse within here would operate before the one in the consumer's unit, therefore not having active selectivity and therefore failing the system in that regards. So in other words, if we have a 20 amp fuse here and a 13 amp fuse here, the ratio is closer to 2 to 1, which we're looking at as a rule of thumb in order to get active discrimination or selectivity depending on when you're watching the video. We installed a number of different fixing methods. We used both male and female adapters to connect to our boxes, and we stated the fact that where we enter things such as our T-box down here, that we would need to glue the conduit into place. We would need to take all the precautions when using glues. So in other words, read the instructions, be in a well-ventilated area, wear PPE such as goggles, gloves, and a mask. And those are questions that will come up in our exam when looking at gluing conduit in situ. We had to bend the PVC conduit ourselves. So we were putting nice, smooth 90 degree bends in. And we said, as previously stated, that the bending radius of conduit is 2.5 times the diameter of the conduit itself. We've been working here with 20 mil conduit. Therefore, we multiply that number by 2.5 to get 50 mil. We set our compass up, we draw a circle with a radius of 50 mil, and that gives us the tightest bending radii that we can have on our conduit. And we were looking to be slightly bigger than that when we pulled ours. But again, the exam will say to you, what is the factor used to work out the bending radius of conduit? And it's 2.5 times the diameter of the conduit. So that's covered some of the recap points required for our installation theory when installing such systems as plastic conduit. Plastic conduit, for recap, PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride, comes in a standard 3 meter length, comes in 4 standard sizes, and it's the diameter of the conduit, 16, 20, 25 and 32 mil. We use high impact. We know it must be installed in a temperature above zero. If it was installed below zero, we've got problems with it shattering or breaking. If it was left outside overnight, it would need to be left in an ambient temperature above zero for 24 hours before we can install it. We know that our ring final circuit has additional sockets taken from it, our fuse spurs or non-fuse spurs. We need to work out how many we can have in relationship to the circuit. So non-fuse spurs can be taken from a ring final circuit to the maximum number of socket outlets on the circuit. In other words, if there's 10 sockets on a ring final circuit, you can take 10 non-fuse spurs, one off each of the socket outlets. Where we install fuse connection units, the maximum size of fuse in there is 13 amps. From that position onwards, you can have as many socket outlets as you wish. We know that a ring final circuit or a socket circuit rated at 20 amps and below under the 17th edition, remembering that's the rated value of the socket fronts, and these are rated at 13 amps. So that's quite key to me. I've just had some sound issues. I've had to come back and reshoot this part of the video again. That's quite key to us, that these socket outlets are rated at 13 amps. Nothing to do with the size of the overcurrent protection device within the consumer's unit. Under the 17th edition, all sockets rated at 20 amps and below need additional protection by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps or below. As we move towards the 18th edition, they're going to change that for socket outlets rated at 32 amps and below need additional protection by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps and below. It's the value of the sockets rated, not the rating of the fuse within the consumer unit, that will distinguish whether or not it will need an RCD protection on it. And that RCD rated at 30 milliamps and below, disconnecting within 40 milliseconds when there's 5 times the current present. In other words, if there's a 30 milliamp RCD protecting the circuit, it will have 150 milliamps under test and disconnect within 40 milliseconds or below. Real key points as we move towards level 3, hence I've reiterated at the end of the video. I hope this video has been some help.